Young.
Mr. Speaker, I'm very pleased to stand and speak about the economic growth and development, particularly in the province in which I represent, which is Taranaki. Mr. Speaker, I have heard today, prior to coming to the House, a statement which says criticism is not an agenda. And the more that the lot over the other side criticise, the more they have got nothing to say. Mr. Speaker, last month I was invited to speak at a function in New Plymouth, in the city in which I live, and it was hosted by a social justice group, and an officer from MSD was one of the panellists and informed the delegates that there were 280 people in the city of New Plymouth who were on the or receiving a benefit because they weren't employed, a city of 50,000 people. If you look at Taranaki as a whole, a population of 110,000, where the unemployment in that region has shrunk by 35% since September 2010. Industry is flourishing, opportunities are increasing, employment is growing. So while they say no, Taranaki is saying yes, and we are flourishing. The biggest reason for Taranaki's success is the responsible and active utilisation of the resources that surround us. And those resources are specifically, as you know, the wealth we walk on and the wealth that is deeper under our feet. We utilise those resources in responsible and careful ways. And New Zealanders are receiving the benefit of a pro-business, pro-growth government that is not selling out on our environmental obligations. The EEZ closes the environmental regulatory gap that existed while those on the other side of this House did nothing when they were in a position to do so. So, Mr. Speaker, the oil and gas sector in Taranaki, as we have heard from the Honourable Anne Tolley, is a world-class industry applying cutting-edge technology and proprietary intellectual property. This has had an amazing flow-on effect into the industries and businesses in the region, but also into the wider community. That particular field of endeavour and business is one of the cornerstones of our economy. It generates 17% of our GDP and, more importantly, it contributes to the capability and the capacity within a number of industries that exist in our region. The exports that come in 2009, $1.9 billion in export value from this industry, 17.5 million barrels of oil. All of these are facts, but they translate into jobs, into an environment of world-class expertise, of developing technology and developing practices that maintain and protect our environment. One of the great things about Taranaki, if you've been there, Mr. Speaker, I'm sure you have, is the pristine environment in which we live, the clear air, the beautiful mountain streams, all of these things which we hold high value of. And I know that many members of this House have been there. And so it is in our interest, and of course the interest of all New Zealanders, that we maintain all of those environmental standards that that have come to deliver a great province and a great environment for us. Mr. Speaker, I have to say that it is nearly laughable that members of the Green Party try and poke and jab the industry in Taranaki and the regulators of that industry, and all the time are trying to throw spanners in the works to say that what is happening is below par. We know that, I mean, if you've ever read the papers that come from our region, the accusation and then the response from the regulators, it's actually poetry in motion. It's like particularly Mr. Hughes would go there and he would try and throw his spin ball, and the TRC in particular, the regulators there, have answers for every one of his accusations, his allegations of impropriety. And Mr. Speaker, we have a tremendous group of regulators there. Recently we heard, Mr. Speaker, that we have had some responses from the TRC that indeed stand up to their great credibility.
Order, Gareth.